Welcome back, aliens. My name is Devin Reddy, and let's continue with the series on JavaScript. In this video, we'll talk about relational operators. Now, what are those? So in the last video, we have talked about arithmetic operators, right? Where you have two operands and then you use an operator in between. So let's say now we have two values and you want to compare them. Maybe you can use a less than symbol, greater than symbol. You want to compare two numbers. Or maybe you want to compare two numbers if they're equal or not. Let's do that in this video. Now, this video is interesting because you can compare different values, right? But there's a twist in this topic. So this is not like all the other languages which you have gone through. Maybe if you have learned other languages like C, C++, Java, it's a bit different in here. So we'll see that at the end of this video. So now let's start with the concept. So let's say, example, let's say we have two variables here. Or maybe we can directly go for console.log and let me just print what exactly we are trying to compare here. So let's say I want to compare two values here. Now, when you say you are comparing, what's the output? So when you compare and when you get the output will be in a Boolean format. Now, this Boolean can be true or false, right? So ultimately, it comes down to that Boolean value. Either you will get true or you will get false, right? Okay, so when I say 5 is greater than 6. Now, in this case, what do you think will be the output? Now, we are comparing two numbers and then we are saying 5 is greater than 6. Now, that's not true, right? So it should give you false. So if you save this and if you run this code, and let's see what the output is. And if you enter this, you can see we got false. Of course, right? It's a false value. Okay, so what I will do now is let me just increase this value. So let me say 7. Now, let's compare and you can see we got true. So that's how you can compare two numbers. Right? But this time what I will do is, so now we know ultimately it's all about true and false, right? So what I will do, let me create a variable and I will say this is bool, so a boolean value. And the operation which we are doing here, or maybe I can say this is data just to keep it simple, right? So now I will say 7 is greater than 6 and instead of printing the comparison here, we are printing data. So it will print either true or false. Okay, we got true because we have not changed data here, we just changed the way we process this. So we have a variable now. It is quite simple when it comes to numbers, right? So let's say if you have two variables and if you want to compare which is greater, so you can do this now. Okay, but let me just make it a bit complex. Can I use less than operator? Of course we can. It will be giving you false, of course, right? 7 is not less than 6. Okay, but what if I have two values which are same? I want to compare if they are equal or less than. So I want the first value to be less than or equal to the second value. In this case, you can use a combination of less than and equal to. If you remember in maths, we do that, right? We say less than and on top of that, draw a line. So the same thing we can do with less than, equal to. Of course, we don't have that symbol on the keyboard, right? So we have to use this. Will this work? Let's try, and it works. We can see we got true. Now the best thing would be you can save this data in a variable. Let's do that quickly. So let's say x is equal to 6. Of course, this is not a best way to write your variable names, but since we are learning, that should work. And now instead of using this 6 and 6, we'll use x and y. So that's how you can perform the operation. We can compare two values. The same thing can be done for greater than equal to. So since they are equal, so it should give you true, right? So you can compare this way. So you can say less than, greater than, equal to. Okay, can we do this for string? Now this is integers or this is numbers. It makes sense, right? You can actually compare numbers. What about if I have a value which is, let's say, pen, and then the second one is book. Now, can you technically compare two string? And how will that work? So let's say I want to compare if the first string is greater than the second string. Can you really do that? And even if you compare them, it is based on what? So think about it, okay? So if you compare two string, what will happen? Think about it, pause the video, comment your answer, and then we'll see what is happening. So let me run this code and let's see what happens. So if you run this code, you can see we got true. Now that's tricky. Why we got true? So it says the first value, which is x, is greater than y, which is pen is greater than book. Might be, but how it is comparing? Is it the philosophical way or it is just a comparing of values? So what is it is doing? So it is comparing each character from start, like dictionary comparisons. So it will start with the first letter. So is it P? Okay, it is B. So P is greater than B in terms of the alphabet number. So what happens is every letter or every character which you use here has a unique number. So we can call them as ASCII values. So let's say capital A is 65, capital Z is some value 91, I guess. So that goes in that number stream. In the same way, here we are comparing those two values. So yes, capital P comes later than capital B, so it is greater. Okay, so if it is that case, can I use a pencil? Now what do you think which is greater here? Of course, pen should be greater than pencil, or let's see, philosophical way, of course, because you can't erase what something you write from pen. But here, if you compare them, you will get false. Why false? It's because, see, it will go for the comparison, right? P, P, okay, same, E, E, same, N, N, same. But it will go ahead, it has a greater length, right? C, okay, so it says pen is over, right? So we still have some characters here, so it is greater. So if you do this, pen is less than pencil, yes, and that's true. Okay, that means we can compare a number and a number. We can compare a string and a string. What happens when you have a number and a string? Let's see what happens. What I will do is, here, the first value we have is, let's say, 2. Simple. The second value is 1. So what happens when you have a comparison like this? 1 is string. Of course, that's a number, but it's a formatting string, right? And the second one is 1. What will happen now? Is it the first one greater than second one? Of course it is, because that's 2 is greater than 1. But we have two different formats here, right? So in this case, it will convert, and you can see we got true. So it will convert this 2 into number. The same thing can be done for the second one. Example, let's have one more. Let's try 3. And this time it should give false, because 2 is not greater than 3. And we got false. That means it is getting converted, right? So 2 is getting converted into a number here. So this is working. Okay, so now we know how to compare number string and string number with each other. So now let's try with a equal to operator. I want to check if two numbers are equal. Let's try. So I have 3 and 3, and I'm comparing them. So what operator should I use? See, if you want to check if two numbers are equal, we have equal to symbol, right? So we can simply say equal. But unfortunately, equal to has a different behavior. Right, so we use equal to for assignment operator. That example, the x is getting assigned with 3. So that's assignment operator. For comparing, we have to use something else. We have to use double equal to. So we got double equal to, and let's compare what happens. And when you compare them, we got true. Simple, right? Okay, what happens when you have this in a string format? So let's say the first letter, the number 3 is in string format, and the second one is integer or number. And we know this, right? It will try to convert this into a number. And let's try. So if you run this code, you can see we got true. But don't you think that should be false? When you try to compare two things and we say it is equal, it means it should have the same data, of course. It should have the same format or type. If it is there, it should be numbers. It should be string. Both should be string. Then we say it is equal. Now this thing is actually coming from the start of JavaScript, and it is very common, right? So double equal to is very common in all the languages, and they also check the type, because all the other languages, or most of the languages, are strictly typed language, and JavaScript is loosely typed, which means it gets converted. Remember type conversion? It gets converted into the other formats, and we don't want that. When I say two numbers are equal, they has to be equal, not just value, but the type as well. And that's why JavaScript says use triple equal to. I know that's tricky for some people, but this is how we do comparison. Never use double equal to, always use triple equal to. Now you will say, why do I have even showed you double equal to? Because even if you come across that thing, you have to ignore that. That's the reason I've shown you, but always use triple equal to. Now, if you do that, it should give you false. That's what expected, okay? See, whenever you write a code, it's not important if you're getting the output. What's important is don't write bugs. Remember, if debugging is removing bugs, then coding is adding bugs. Okay, so every time you write a new line of code, you may be adding bugs in your code. So things like this has to be considered. Okay, this works, right? So we have to use triple equal to. Now let me show you something more about double equal to and why it is risky. So let's say I have an empty string here, and then this is false. Now if you can see, we have two different type of data. We have empty string and we have false. And then when you compare them with double equal to, and if you run this, you can see we got true. Now that's tricky. Now this is happening because, if you remember, we have talked about conversion and we have talked about truthy value, falsy value. So this is actually false, right? So empty string is false. So the best way to avoid that is with the help of triple equal to. So when you do triple equal to now, it will give you false. This is what we want. Okay, so just to reiterate, when we use double equal to, it is only checking the value, not the type. If you are using triple equal to, it will check the type and data as well. So imagine comparing type of and then comparing the value. So yeah, that's it from this video. I hope you enjoyed. Now you know how to compare two values. In the next video, we'll see how do you compare multiple conditions. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section and do subscribe for further videos. Bye-bye.